Hey JR, you're showing us how to cut with the vinyl cutter today?
Absolutely. I'm going to walk you through the basic steps of cutting vinyl. So first of all, the vinyl software is installed on this computer. There's several different programs to choose from, but we're going to use the stuff that actually came with the program. That is LXI. Now, I would typically work in Inkscape first and then bring the SVG into LXI. I'm going to go ahead and open that program up. So it's your standard design sort of layout. I'm going to go ahead and import some sort of shape. Here's a light bulb. And I'm going to place it on the page. Now, what I want to do before cutting is just make sure that I have my vinyl cutter set up. So first things first, am I plugged in? I am in fact plugged in via USB. Am I plugged in as far as power? I am, absolutely. Now I'm going to want to choose what vinyl I'm going to cut. So there's two main types of vinyl that I know about. Vinyls that you can use for a sign, and then there's another type which you can iron onto a t-shirt. I can show you over here that this sign stuff has a glossy looking finish, and the stuff that you might use for a t-shirt is got a little bit of a different texture. You should also just check the any labeling that's on the material so that you know the difference and you're using the right material for the right job. I'm gonna load this by moving the springs on the back. There are these wheels that the vinyl travels over and that they have different states from the levers on the back. You're gonna wanna make sure that you put it in a position so that the wheels are traveling up above. Then I'm going.
And what's important about those wheels?
It's really important that they are even, that they're not worn. Otherwise,
what's important still?
Why don't you tell
me? After you're done cutting, you want to lift those wheels up again.
Okay.
That's really important because if you leave them down, the wheels get dense, and if they get dense, they don't track the material right anymore.
Okay. So, well, that is a good tip.
After cutting, always put the wheels back up.
So I'm going to feed this through awkwardly. I'm going to fail at feeding this through. Okay. This is where editing comes into play. Alright. Oh, come on. Am I doing something wrong here?
No, it's just that lip that catches it.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Okay. So, now I have fed it through under the wheels and they're loose. I can actually slide the wheels over so that I have full coverage on my piece here. I'm going to go ahead and move it over. There's a little score mark that shows where the printer head goes to. And so I'm going to line it up there. I can use one of these ridges to make sure my vinyl is straight. If my vinyl is not straight, it's going to slowly go out of whack, especially.
Correct.
Especially if you are cutting a long sign. So this doesn't have a really clean cut. It's a little hard for me to tell.
Actually, the best way of doing it is you use the side of the vinyl as a guide, because the side of the vinyl is always straight, because that was cut on the machine where the vinyl was produced. So we go with the tick mark that's right here, and then with the tick mark that's
here in
the back.
Oh, we do have a tick mark there.
And if we line up both of those tick marks with the edge of the vinyl, we know that the vinyl is tracking completely straight.
Cool.
So then you don't have to worry about that getting out of alignment.
All right. So I'm going to put the wheels into their down position since we look pretty aligned.
I'm going to be a pain in the ass and I'm going to jump in again.
Do it.
You want to make sure that that first wheel moves over to the edge right here. The center wheel, you kind of want to have centered at the material. So we're moving that all the way over. Yep.
And then
the center one, we center about.
Is that pretty centered?
Yep. Looks pretty good. And that one we're moving out to a little bit
farther. Oh, you want it right way over.
About like that. So we get the best coverage, basically, of those wheels.
Okay. Sounds good. Now, there's a couple of settings here on the control pad. There's one for the intensity with which the knife will cut, and another one for the speed in which the knife will cut. Now, the trick is, if you have the speed too far out, the software sending it will send it either too fast or too slow, and then you'll get an incomplete cut. We were having some trouble with that earlier. We will have the correct settings certainly on the website. We want to make sure that when you're cutting, that you're cutting through the top vinyl, but not through the support material on bottom. The thing that actually does the cutting is this little knife here. And inside of this housing is a little blade on a swivel. And that should be just above the this little bulbous area.
So a good rule of thumb is, if you have a credit card, just hold the credit card next to the blade, and it should be about half the thickness of the credit card should be exposed.
Sounds good to me. So I'm going to put it in here and have it just raised up a little bit. That looks about right, Marcus. I'm going to tighten it down. So one of the things we can do is we should be able to put it into a test mode, where I will click test. Maybe I have to go online and then test. So it drew a little square. Now what I can do is move it. So when you're on or offline, this moves between changing your speed and your pressure to moving the vinyl back and forth. Now we can take a look at the square and the results. It actually didn't look like it cut too well there, as far as I can tell.
Yeah, I think we need to go a little bit farther down with that one.
Yeah, so...
I think I had it about...
Make sure we get the shot.
About right here.
Okay.
Let's give that another shot.
Grab it for a second. All right, that looks like a better cut.
That looks good. Okay. And we can now feel on the bottom. It's not cut through, so.
Cool. Yeah, there's nothing. All right. Well, now we have the system set up. We have the file. So here's our light bulb. What we're going to do is we're going to go up to the top to this little picture of a blade. I don't know if you can get a closer shot of that, Marcus. There's a little blade picture. And that little blade will bring up a screen in just one second. And this is the plotting screen. Now this is going to show you, okay, we'll bring up two screens. This is kind of like the driver screen. You should be able to ignore it because the settings should already be set. Behind it, here is what you're looking for, which is this cutter plotter screen. And on it, you'll see that there indicates the direction that the vinyl is going to be coming out of the printer, and there'll be a little preview of what you're going to be cutting. There's a whole set of options inside of here. For example, you can do settings that will help you with what's called weeding. We'll also make little cross cuts, basically, so that you can more easily pick the unwanted vinyl off of the paper. As well as some other settings. I'm not going to get into those right now because I just want to show you the very basic principle. So when I click send, this should actually go to the... I'm going to click online. I click the online button on the printer, and I'm going to click send. That looks like a successful cut.
Looks like a light bulb.
Yep. So I'm now going to take it to the feed mode, and I'm just going to feed it backwards out, actually. And I have this little light bulb. The next step is actually going to be how we would place it onto the sticky mat. But why don't we stop the camera, since this is a good